Julian Joshua Brett Benson was born at Kennedy Hospital in Stratford, New Jersey on April 8, 1988. From his day of birth, Julian brought joy to the life of his family, and for 21 years, he was fortunate enough to be surrounded by the same neighbors and friends in his hometown of Sickleville, New Jersey. As a child, Julian is described as curious, independent, fearless, and happy. Traits that he took and magnified later in his adulthood. Julian attended Winslow Junior and Senior High School. During those years is when he began to recognize his gift to communicate. At the same time, he touched the lives of his peers with his positive attitude and captivating charm. After graduating from Winslow High School, Julian set his sights on the campus of The Morgan State University, located in Baltimore, Maryland.
As a Morgan alum, when Julian decided to attend Morgan, I was really proud. Julian had first started out by not really being interested in going to college. But as we kept pushing him and he decided to go to Morgan, we were really just happy. He would be close to me. He had family support. So I was really overjoyed when he got an opportunity to come here. I described Julian as a person who had a real spirit. And when you talk to people, that's one of the first things that come up. His spirit was just helping people. He always had a warm spirit about himself, but he had a personality that made people really comfortable.
I came to Morgan January 2006, and pre-college at the time started that summer. And I was an academic advisor. I actually met Julian probably July of 2006. My first impression of Julian, it was too cute. We were in the old Banneker building, and this kid came and sat down at my desk, and he had these big R. Kelly-esque, diamond-esque earrings in his ear, and I knew he was from up north somewhere. And so he introduced himself, and he just told me that he wasn't supposed to be there. So at the time that I met him, I was advising him on, you know, classes, just talking to get to know him. And from there, you know, we developed our relationship as an academic advisor and advisee.
We were in a program that was known then as pre-college. I remember after the conversation of me basically not wanting to speak to him, he walked away and was saying that, you know, that he hoped that I changed my mind about being here, because he was 2 weeks in and he said that he was already loving it.
Choosing communications as his major with a concentration in radio broadcasting, Julian quickly made friends and formed bonds so strong that he later described those same friends as brothers and sisters. While winning over the hearts of administrators and beginning his journey just 3 weeks into the program of catching the attention of an entire student body, campaigning for the Student Government Association's Mr. Freshman, a campus king position that allowed him to represent the graduating class of 2010.
The boy was literally everywhere. From everywhere you would go on campus, you would see Julian advertising, promoting himself to be Mr. Freshman. And it got to the point where one time I was walking to my dorm, tired from track practice, and he was out there again. Like, every time he would see me, he would ask me, "Are you gonna vote for me? Are you gonna vote for me?" And I just finally say, "Yes, I'm gonna vote for you." And that was just, from then on, I didn't really have a relationship with him right away. It was just more so him being a dominant figure on campus and just kind of seeing him around.
He was definitely a shiner. He was definitely someone who stood out because he approached me. I didn't know him. I really hadn't seen him before except for on the flyers around campus. But he was very approachable. He came right up to me, introduced himself. And even though he seemed to be very popular, what I really liked about him was that he was sort of humble and he didn't have a problem just stepping down and talking to people that he didn't even know.
Anything he did, he definitely put 110% in it, and he never quit whatever he was doing, and he was always on a different move, a different hustle, but he definitely gave it 100%.
Not stopping with his involvement in the SGA, Julian also became a member of the Morgan Mile and Fashion at Morgan, all of which let him flourish as a leader.
As far as the Morgan Mile went and Julian's participation in Morgan Mile, it was in his first year that he really was active in it. And at that time, we did a lot of traveling and we had a lot of events. The trip to New Orleans was a hard trip for everyone. Going down there and seeing the destruction and how much people need our help. And Julian was always very happy and very gleeful to help anyone. And you know, he played around a lot, but I think it was there for the first time I really saw him during our friendship. First time me seeing the serious Julian.
The next year, Julian went on to also take the position of Mr. Sophomore, once again providing the campus of Morgan State with memorable programming and events. During this same time, Julian's professional journey also began debuting his first online radio show, Real Talk, which highlighted both campus and community leaders and events.
The concept of Real Talk was kind of what it was in the title, was Real Talk. Julian's idea for that was to basically represent the true Morgan man and basically to have a voice. He definitely wanted to touch all angles, but he called it Real Talk because for our age group, he was definitely keeping it real during the show. I think my favorite show had to be the show where we brought in the guy Joe, who does poetry. So when he came and said, yeah, you know, we're gonna have some of his poetry on there, I'm like, it's gonna be boring, nobody wants no poetry. And when Joe started doing that poetry, I remember Julian's face, because Joe was standing right here, and Julian was just, as Joe was talking, Julian was just like, ooh, I just wish I could talk like that. Like, he had so much energy with that episode, and we had so much fun that day.
Off campus, he began working for Baltimore's own radio station, 92Q, where he worked with radio personalities of the Big Fat Morning Show, in addition to serving as a marketing team representative for Atlantic Records and becoming the face for Downtown Locker Room's Fall 2008 Evolution campaign.
I met Julian, I guess, how many years ago? He walked in as a bright-eyed, bushy-tailed, well, he was tired, I guess, because early in the morning, interned for the Big Fat Morning Show on 92Q. I was the morning show producer and on-air personality with Mark Clark and the Big Fat Morning Show, and he was one of our interns. My first impression of Julian, he was a cute young guy, and you know, he seemed enthusiastic to learn, but he also seemed like, you know, I could do this. Like, he had a little swag to him compared to the other interns.
As Julian found great success and achievement in the career moves that he was making, he still had unfinished business on the campus of Morgan State. Julian exploded back onto campus, now campaigning for the greatest position, Mr. Morgan State University 2009-2010. He broke new ground in his quest for Mr. Morgan State University, creating a unique campaign that paid homage to dominant figures in American culture like recording artist Kanye West and our very own President Obama. As campus king, Julian produced some of the most innovative programs and events that the campus had ever seen in its history.
Julian as a Mr. Morgan, I say this guy was like Hove. He was Jay-Z. That's point blank.
Julian Benson as Mr. Morgan was, and this is my example, he was probably the ideal Mr. Morgan, because it was like he was a people's person. He was himself. He didn't fit any of the stereotypes of Mr. Morgan. It was like he made Mr. Morgan. It was like you think, okay, you have Mr. Morgan, and people think Mr. Morgan is this. He's like either some popular Greek or party promoter thing like that. And it was like you look at Julian, and it's like he's none of that, but he still perfectly fits what a Mr. Morgan is.
Julian was an excellent Mr. Morgan. Very unconventional. It was an honor to serve as his queen, because we just kind of meshed well together, and that was like my first real interaction with Julian. He always wanted to do things bigger and better, and on the flip side of that, he was always a gentleman to me, to the other queens, to the women on campus.
I remember one of the biggest events he did was King's Cater to You by Mr. Morgan and all the Morgan State Kings, and We did a series of events. We shut the whole student center down. He brought all of us together and to show the ladies of Morgan State a good time, that we appreciate them, that we love them. And he really killed the game on that one. He really killed the game.
After his Mr. Morgan tenure, Julian began interning for the Maryland Transit Administration in the marketing department, where he complied voiceovers for various radio advertisements and was instrumental in helping develop MTA's marketing slogan, Ride, Respect, and Relax. And if you see something, say something. Public safety campaigns.
Working at the MTA, Julian was very passionate about what he did. You know, I remember like this past summer, you know, he was working on a blog for the MTA. He would always, he just always had new ideas, and he was a very passionate person about everything he did, and he always got things done with a smile on his face.
Julian also refocused his attention on a more personal goal and business venture. Returning back to his love for media in September of 2011, Julian launched Where's Julian? A video diary documenting his life travels with family and friends. Through this project, the world was able to see the vibrant soul that those close to him knew and loved greatly. Where's Julian was just one lasting example that showcased the fact that Julian never stopped giving and he never stopped living.
The idea of Where's Julian came from a conversation in the MTA's office. He came in there, he said, I got an idea for a blog. And I was like, okay, tell me about it. And he told me his ideas and what he wanted to do. And I was like, okay, that's good, but we gotta work on, you know, how to structure it and how to make it, you know, good. The whole concept, we would be following him around on his journey, you know, his experiences, life with his friends, you know, just having a good time, promoting different places within Baltimore City.
I remember like just one day, he just called me and was like, yo, we gotta hang out and talk about something. He was like, yeah, I wanna do a video blog. My roommate was talking about, I got a cameraman, we're ready to go. Like, just need to get the idea popping. And like, what do you think of him? I'm like, that's great. Like, honestly, it's like most people who try to do stuff like that don't really have that much like thought into it because they just wanna like do a show, they have no ideas. But he had like all his, like, he had his idea, he had his vision already set.
My favorite Where's Julian episode would be episode number 3 when they jumped off the cliff into the water. He really enjoyed his life and loved it. And I felt like that was the most important episode to me. That was my favorite episode. Just seeing him enjoy his life and doing what he loved to do and just being different. You know, being outside of the box and actually doing other things to make him happy.
Tragically, on the night of October 20th, 2011, Julian was suddenly taken from us in an unfortunate car accident at the tender age of 23, leaving the loved ones he left behind both saddened and yet grateful to have known such a genuine and loving spirit.
The way he was that whole day was just how everybody remembers him. He was outgoing, he was funny, he was charismatic. So I remember him like just asking like, are you okay? And I was like, yeah, I'm good. Are you okay? And he was like, yeah, I'm good. And that's the last thing I remember him saying. That kind of resonates with me. Like that's the type of person he was just to think about somebody else, how they're doing, how they're feeling.
When I heard of Julian's passing, it's just unbelievable. You can't describe it, not just because he was a young guy, but he was everything to our family. And what I mean by that is, we expected him to live forever, do great things. He did that in a small amount of time that he was here, but it still hurts every day.
I think one of the things that I would have told Julian before he passed was, I think just letting him know that I appreciate him and everything he's done, because one of the things that people forget to do is people forget to let everyone who has impacted them, who has been part of their life, that they appreciate them. I think we walk by, we get caught up in this competition, this ego battle, we get caught up in the he say, she says, and just media and just life, and I think we forget to let everybody know that we appreciate each other.
Now, because of Julian's tenacity and dedication to both self-growth and professional development, we have created a scholarship in remembrance of him that will be hosted right here at Morgan State University.
The Julian Benson Scholarship is basically a fund that's going to allow Julian's legacy to live, and the money is going to be given to Morgan students who basically exemplify all of Julian's characteristics. And I think it gives his friends an opportunity to put all of that negative energy and that pain and that hurt behind Julian's death into something positive that is going to uplift another Morgan student, because that's exactly what Julian would have wanted us to do.
This scholarship is an honor and celebration of Julian Benson, a young man who loved life and all of those in his life. And whether during his work for various media ventures, community service, or his time as Morgan's king, Julian left footprints on the hearts of those who had the pleasure of knowing him. Never complacent with his victories and always striving to achieve the very best and seeking out the very best in others, Julian famously stated after every accomplishment, "The legacy continues." It is no doubt that he fulfilled his purpose of leaving a legacy.
You know, everybody got to see Julian when he passed, but I wasn't able to see him. But one thing I can remember is that night when I went to sleep, Julian came to me in a dream, and I actually went in the hospital and got to see him, and he actually walked out the hospital with me. So metaphorically, I believe Julian's still with me right now.
I wanna leave my footprints on the sands of time. Know there was something that meant something that I left behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regrets. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here. Ah!